October 27th. This is usually one of my favorite days of the year. I don't know why, but I've seen a lot of big deer on the 27th in previous years. Wind seems to be good. I'm up, got up really high. Maybe catch a break with my wind if I get something close, but should be good. It's been pretty steady so far, so we're gonna sit tight and hopefully some deer move out here a little later on. October 31st, Halloween. I am walking in about to access a stand from the river. I'm gonna cross the river and get in this set and let my wind blow back to the river rather than walk across the other piece to get in there. So I think this will be better. It just rained, so I think the river will be up some, so I don't want to fill my boots up before I hunt. So we'll see what we can do. That did not work. A good thing it's not cold, because that was deeper than it looked.
I talk really quiet because it is so unbelievably still right now. There is zero wind. I really don't know what my scent's doing. And they called for 5 or 6 mile an hour, but I can't even tell which way it's blowing. I'm hoping the wind will pick up a little bit just to carry my scent out of here some. But Ronica's great blind, a buck I'm hunting, has been coming through here every now and then, not super regular, but he's been in here some. And it just rains, so you would think that a buck would want to come through and freshen up his sign. November 7th, one of the days you kind of look forward to every year. It is hot, it's 83 degrees right now. We've been plagued with hot weather recently. We've had about 8 or 10 really, really slow hunts in a row. It's still November 7th, the deer still got to move some, regardless of the weather, so we have colder weather coming in about 5 days, so I think the action will pick up even though the dates are probably never better than they are right now. November 9th. It is 46 degrees this morning. This is by far the coldest weather we've had in November thus far. This is the first year I've hunted this track, and I really hadn't gotten to see it break loose yet, so I'm excited to see if we finally have some bugs move through here on a little creek drain. There's some good trails, good water oaks and stuff like that on it, so there ought to be some does moving through here and hopefully some bugs traveling it. I just had a deer come by before daylight, and it sounded like a buck the way he was moving. Makes me think it was a buck with his nose to the ground, so I don't know. I'd like to know what that deer was, but he was out cruising. Hopefully this place will heat up a little bit with this weather.
Oh man, I don't deserve it. I don't deserve it. I don't know how I just killed that deer. I don't know how. He was behind me. That is the biggest bind I've ever been in with this camera and a bow trying to kill a buck. I don't know how big he is, but he got me fired up. And that is all. That's why I do it.
Golly. I throttled him.
I thought he was leaving. And I grunted and rattled. And two bucks came in, two little ones came in behind me, and that made him come over here.
What?
I heard him go down.
Was that a good one?
Yeah. He crossed the creek 50 yards to my right, started thrashing a tree, went back behind me across this cutover stuff, and I turned around and rattled behind me, and I guess he thought it was down in this creek bottom where he couldn't see it, and he came about halfway back to me. I had to sit there and play with him forever. He wouldn't come. I was trying to rattle him, wouldn't come. And finally, some two little bucks came in from behind me across the creek, and one of them came across and up beside me, and he saw that thing and then heard another buck down in here, and he came on a beeline and tried to run him off, and I just shot him at like 23 yards.
Alright, well, man, put my shoes on and I'll ride over this.
Alright.
Parked out on the road.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay. Bye. Just walking up to my arrow. He's standing behind this little bush. That looks pretty good to me.
Broken in.
Yep.
Oh, that was